proclamation. I'm going to recognize Senator Davis, and we'll come back to you, Senator Jackson. Senator Davis?
Thank you, Mr. President. I'd ask for a personal privilege, if I might.
Granted.
Thank you. We have coming to the floor right now, Nasimi Aghayev, who's the Consul General of Azerbaijan. His consular district represents the western states, and this is his first trip to Utah. And we have a citation to present to him on behalf of the state of Utah and the Utah Senate and House. Azerbaijan, if I can give you a brief geography lesson to the body, it's located on the western coast of the Caspian Sea. It's the home of more than 70 different ethnic groups. In 1918, the people of Azerbaijan established the first secular democratic republic in the Islamic world and were the first Muslim nation to grant women the right to vote. Azerbaijan was forcefully incorporated into the Soviet Union from the year 1920 until October of 1991, when the country's independence was restored. Since independence, Azerbaijan has become one of the most rapidly developing countries in the world and the biggest United States trading partner in the Southern Caucasus. Azerbaijan accounts for 80% of the region's economy and has vast oil and gas resources. Azerbaijan and the United States have a long history of partnership, connected by similar values and interests. Together, the two countries have worked on a multifaceted cooperation on several issues that promote regional security, economic, energy development, diversity, and inclusiveness. Nasimi Aghayev, the Consul General, has been serving Azerbaijan's diplomatic service since 1999. He was appointed by the Azerbaijan President, Elim Aliyev, as Consul General of Azerbaijan in Los Angeles in 2012. His consular district includes Utah and 12 other U.S. states. And I'd like to welcome him to the floor, if I might, Mr. President.
Welcome. Senator Davis.
If I might read the citation. The Republic of Azerbaijan is a strong partner of the United States. Azerbaijan has ancient traditions of interfaith tolerance, inclusion, and positive multiculturalism, and offers an environment where Muslims, Jews, and Christians enjoy peaceful coexistence because of the respect and tolerance of the Azerbaijani people. The government has fostered an environment of interfaith tolerance, mutual acceptance, because it sees diversity as one of the country's great strengths. Azerbaijan has brought together religious leaders from around the world to promote interfaith dialogue. And this year, 2016, is a year of multiculturalism in Azerbaijan, and they will host the United Nations Alliance of Civilization Forum in April. Azerbaijan's Consulate General has built a remarkable relationship with the Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints and has co-hosted the largest Azerbaijani LDS event under the motto, Musical Celebration of Tolerance and Interfaith Harmony, with 800 guests in attendance. This took place last fall in Los Angeles at a stake center. Now, therefore, let it be known that the Utah State Legislature hereby recognizes the long-standing traditions of interfaith tolerance, inclusion, and harmony in Azerbaijan, and applaud their efforts to foster these traditions.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. And if I might go to a committee of the whole to hear from the Consul General.
Okay, that's an appropriate motion. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
Any opposed? That motion passes. Welcome, and love to hear from you.
Great pleasure to be in Utah, and one of the most tolerant and harmonious states in the United States of America. And that's what is the best place, actually, for this citation, which we truly appreciate. With its example, Azerbaijan shows to the world that it's possible for Muslims, Christians, and Jews, and representatives of other faiths to live together in peace, dignity, and mutual respect. I'm looking forward to continued relationship with the Utah and with the legislature. And thanks again for your friendship and warm reception. Thank you.